Welcome to MooMooMath, where we upload a new math video every day. In this video, I'd like to go over the steps for creating a frequency table. A frequency table organizes data into categories to show the frequency of each. You can think of the frequency of how often something occurs. Step one is determine your intervals. 4 to 7 different intervals is ideal. Step two, draw your frequency table. Step three, tally the data in each interval. A word or two about your intervals. The intervals need to be equal, non-overlapping, and able to contain all the data points. Let's see what this means. If your data range is between 2 and 38, let's do this and not this. Let's do this because you have 1 to 10, 11 to 20, 21 to 30. Notice that there is no overlap. Let's not do this. We have 1 to 10, and then we have overlap here of the 10, and then we have overlap again here of the 20. Okay? Let's do this. It goes up by 8, 1 to 8, 9 to 16, 17 to 24, and not this. Notice it goes up by 10, and then 15, and then I think this is 9. Okay? They are unequal. And finally, this looks pretty good, but it only goes up to 30 and it doesn't include all the data because remember the data goes up to 38. Now let's get started on a frequency table. And here is our prompt. It says, the list shows the average high temperatures for 20 cities on one March day. Make a frequency table of the data. Let's next go over what is actually in your frequency table. And let me just quickly point out a couple highlights. First, you have an overall title of your frequency table. You then have a column for your intervals, and notice that you have a title for your intervals. You have a tallies column, and then the frequency column. So each frequency table in some way needs those ingredients. Now, the data is conveniently set in descending order. So step one is we need to, remember from this, need to determine your intervals. And so let's start with the low. So we get kind of the range. We go between the low of 2 and the high of 69. Well, I know that I want 4 intervals, so I'm going to round this. I'm going to round the 2 to 0 and the 69 to 80 because that's a nice number, and I know 80 divided by 4 equals 20. So my intervals are going to be around 20, and if you'll notice, I have my data table set up, so there's not overlap, 0 to 19, there's no overlap, 20 to 39, 40 to 59, 60 to 79, they're equal, and they include the entire data set. I next just start doing tallies, and the easiest thing to do with a frequency table is just to make mistakes and leave out numbers. So to help prevent this, do a check and then a tally. So 69, then I'll do a tally. 66, then a tally. 65, and then a tally. I then move to 51, and I'm in a different row, so I'll put a tally. 50, tally. 50, tally. Don't get lazy and not put a check in a tally. Then when I get to 41, I'm going to draw a line like this, and this tells you that there is a group of 5. I next move to 38, move to the next row, put a check for 32, check for 32, check for 28, check for 20. Yes, we still are in that row, so I do another mark for 5. And then finally, check for 18, check for 12, check for 8, check for 8, check for 4, check for 2, and a check for 2. Okay, then if you really want to be careful, you can total up. We know that we have 20 numbers here, and I could go, I have 5, 10, 15, 18, 20, so I know that I have done all my numbers. I then just total my frequency, 5 plus 2 is 7, and this is 5, this is 5, and then this is 3. And there we go, we've got a nice frequency table. I also have created a frequency, cumulative frequency table. I'll leave a link below. Thanks for watching. Hope this helps with creating a frequency data table. MooMooMath uploads a new math video every day.